The popular surprise egg toys inspired me to make my very own holiday versions. These make for fun gifts, so I wanted to share how simple it is to create your very own surprise inside. Download the hinged Christmas tree or gift box files from the links below. Both of these designs print in place and open by the double hinge on the bottom, allowing them to open to 180 degrees. You can create a unique custom surprise for the inside or download an existing file from Creality Cloud, Thangs, or other 3D model sites. For this example, I'll create a star-shaped tree topper, though keep in mind the surprise doesn't have to be an accessory. We'll want to make sure the entire object is filled in, allowing us to cut the entire shape out of the tree body. I'll copy this component, making sure to use Paste New, which will keep this copy unique. Hide the original to keep it safe for 3D printing and make sure the copy is active in the browser. Looking inside, you'll see it's hollow and it has a bar that goes into the tree. Fusion 360 will let us select the interface followed by pressing the delete key. This will self-repair the geometry and fill the void based on the adjacent geometry. Try an adjacent face if you don't get the desired results the first time. I'll activate this top-level assembly so we're ready to move this star into place. Relocating your surprise is one of the most critical steps. You'll want to consider the best orientation to ensure it will fit inside and print without supports. Remember that we'll also need to factor in a clearance. We need to move this star to the lower half of the tree, so I'll use the move command to position it. It looks like negative 63 millimeters will work well. We'll also want to capture the position, which will record this move in the timeline. This workflow is ideal as Fusion 360 does not allow joints with a mesh body. To cut the star or your chosen surprise object from the inside, we'll need to make sure we're working with the same types of 3D bodies. If you model both parts in Fusion 360, then you're all set. In my case, I currently have the star as a solid B-Rep body, while the tree is a mesh body. As far as the software works, these are two different languages that cannot interact unless you convert one. We can bounce over to the Mesh tab and choose the Tessellate option. Select the desired bodies to convert to mesh bodies. Set the refinement to high to ensure the accuracy of the shape. It's important to note, Fusion 360's newer mesh tools and this workflow will make it easier than converting a large mesh file to a solid body. We can also make this tree model easier to cut by looking at the inside. Imported mesh files often come as a single mesh body, even if there is more than one part. Using the Separate command in the Mesh tab, we can select the mesh body to create individual bodies using the default mesh shells type. In the browser, I now have four individual mesh bodies. Keep an eye out for any warning signs. We can select the warning icon and stitch and remove the openings in the mesh body. Renaming your bodies is also well worth it, helping us to select the correct one. Renaming bodies also makes it easier to hide the desired tree and star. One last thing before we cut away the surprise inside. You need to factor in clearance, ensuring the final 3D printed object fits. We can do this quickly with the scale feature. Fusion 360 offers a scale feature for both the solid and mesh bodies. Be sure to select the correct one based on their color. With the scale mesh feature, we'll select the body to scale. Note that it will automatically place the point at which the body scales. You'll want to clear this out in the dialog and choose a specific point on the model. I'll select where it snaps to the center of the star. Finally, the scale factor will allow you to define how much to scale. Keep in mind this is in percentages and not a unit of measurement. I've found 1.1 works well, but you can also use 1.15 as a safer bet, especially if you'd like to print it out faster. Remember to follow the same process for the opposite side. If you happen to be working with solid B-Rep bodies, you can always choose to use the offset faces feature to factor in your clearance instead of scaling. Lastly, use the cut operation in the combine tool, making sure to select solid or mesh per the type of body you're working with. Combine does limit us to one target body at a time, so you'll need to use the feature twice, one for each half. We can also uncheck keep tools as this star mesh body was intended only for the cut operation. After clicking OK, this may take a few seconds to process depending on the complexity of the mesh bodies. If yours does happen to fail, you can split the mesh bodies into two or more sections and cut them out one at a time. you'll see my tree topper is cut nicely from the inside of the tree. Turn your visual style to shaded and turn the face groups off in the mesh display setting. These settings will help you look for clean and expected geometry before exporting to the slicer. Of course, don't forget to cut out the mesh on the second half as well. Looking at your model in wireframe mode is a great way to triple check that everything is aligned and cut out as desired. You're then all set and ready to send it to your slicing software. Don't forget to export your original surprise as a separate mesh file. The hinged gift box and Christmas tree templates are for the December 3D Modeling Challenge, sponsored by Creality Cloud. Be sure to download the templates from the links in the description and upload your surprise inside models by the end of the month to win gift cards, Fusion 360 course access, and additional prizes. I'm excited to partner up with Creality, the makers of the highly reviewed and affordable Ender 3D printers. Their mission is well aligned with PDO, as we're both making 3D printing and CAD education accessible, respectively. Creality Cloud is the first all-in-one 3D printer platform, including the ability to download and share 3D models. One of my favorite things is that you can slice 3D models and generate G-code on your mobile phone or tablets, as it's all web-based and doesn't require a native computer application. Creality Cloud also includes free Lithophane and MoonMaker apps, as well as the ability to monitor and control your Creality 3D printers remotely. Head to productdesignonline.com/challenge to see the latest challenge, including the theme and prizes. Be sure to subscribe if you haven't already, and check out our playlist, Learn Fusion 360 for 3D Printing.